Hello, I'm Ed Brorain, an applications specialist for Agilent Technology Systems Product Division. Today I'll be talking about how to test the load regulation of a voltage regulator, and this will be quick and easily accomplished using the N6782A source measure module for functional test. This module both source and sink current, so it's an ideal as both a voltage source and an electronic load. Together with the N6705B DC power analyzer mainframe, it forms an ideal platform for testing components like DC voltage regulators and other power management circuitry. Here I have wired up a 3-pin linear regulator. I've set it up for 10 volt operation, and I have its input connected to one channel of the N6705B, where there's a DC power module installed to power it. And the output is connected to channel 2 of the DC power analyzer mainframe, again, where a second module is acting as an electronic load to load its output. I am also using the 14585 control and analysis software. This software provides an easy way to control and set up the N6705B mainframe, as well as display the results. Pretty much everything you can do on this software, you can also do on the front panel of the N6705B mainframe as well. Here on our diagram, we have display of DC load regulation. And DC load regulation is the change of the output voltage from a high level to a low level in response to the DC loading going from a minimum current to a maximum current. And what we have here, again, is we have N6782A as a source module providing a fixed 15 volts into the voltage regulator. And we have a second load module, an N6782, drawing a pulse current out of the output of the voltage regulator. The N6782 has high-speed digitizing readback for its output voltage and current, so it'll directly capture our current and voltage waveforms so we can measure the load regulation response to the load regulator very easily. Here we have the 14585 control and analysis software user interface controlling the DC power analyzer mainframe. And the first thing we need to do is set up our instrument control. So here on the right, I'll pull up a control panel for setting the instrument settings. And let me set up output 2 here. And we need to set up output 2 as an electronic load. As you can see, we've set it up for CC load operation. We have a pull-down menu here that allows us to quickly set up outputs for any kind of configuration we need, whether it's a source or a load, for example. We have set it up for minus 50 milliamps of DC bias drain current. It's negative because it's operating as a load, not a source. We'll go to output 1 and we'll set it up as a voltage source. Here we've set it up as a two-channel, two-quadrant power supply in voltage priority to provide 15 volts of bias to our device under test. So now we've set up the DC bias conditions for our device under test. But for load regulation, we need to set up a pulse loading condition on our load or our second output. And for that, we need to use an ARB function or an arbitrary waveform function, which we do have built into this platform for that purpose. So I'll go into our ARB setup screen. And here we are able to set up ARB functions on the outputs for this kind of application. And down at the bottom here, I'm applying the ARB sequence to output 2 current to be able to pull a pulse load current from our device under test. So here is our pulsed ARB waveform, and it starts out at a minus 50 milliamps. That's our DC quiescent bias condition. And we're pulsing down to minus 500 milliamps. That's our full load condition. And then we go back to our quiescent state again. And I'm pulsing a very short duration It's a 5% duty cycle in order to minimize the heating effect on our device under test. So now we're done setting up our load conditions, and now we need to set up our measurement conditions. For that, I'll need to go back into our oscilloscope screen and set up our measurement conditions. So when we're now back into our oscilloscope display screen, and what I have here down on the bottom is I've set up our vertical and horizontal scaling factors. I have 2 milliseconds per division. Here I'm setting up and selecting output 2 voltage and current because we want to measure the load voltage and load current. And I've set up my triggering accordingly to capture the waveforms of the current and voltage. So now that I've set up our measurement conditions, all I need to do now is run it to capture our results. In order to do that, I'll first start up the oscilloscope function, capture, by clicking on this icon. It's now in a starting mode, but it's waiting for a trigger. And as soon as I start up our ARB function, it'll provide the current that'll start the trigger. And now you can see we've captured our voltage and current waveforms of the output loading of this device under test to capture load regulation. And what we have here is on the top, we have our load current pulsing down to 500 milliamps of full load condition. And then we have our output voltage in response to that load condition. And so I need to measure the DC levels at both no load and full load condition. So we have markers for that purpose. And let me place the markers on an unloaded portion of the waveform. And so I have captured a portion of that waveform. And if I go down to the numerical results here, I'll see that I have an average current of 10.029 volts. Now let me move the markers to the loaded portion. And I see I now have 10.015 volts roughly. That equates to roughly 14 millivolts of load regulation, which out of 10 volts output is about 0.14%, which is about what you would expect for a linear regulator. And so this is an approach you can take for testing the load regulation of a DC voltage regulator, made easy and quick using an N6782 source measure module for functional test, the N6705 DC power analyzer, and the 14585 software. Thank you.